wonderful to have you guys back at the festival.
You're
festival regulars, and it's really, really terrific. And I've got a couple of questions before we start.
Hello, everybody. We just want to quickly thank Jen Salke and Julie Rappaport and everybody at Amazon.
Thank you, guys.
Amazing. Thank you, guys.
Hard to get these movies made, so it's really nice when people get back.
And they're great with the Prime.
Yeah, very, very good Prime. Nice. Listen, my mother-in-law is here tonight, so... listen, guys, if you don't like the movie, keep it to yourselves. It's going to be embarrassing. But listen, it was 15 years ago Grant and I got to come to the London Film Festival with Good Night and Good Luck. And so it's a real honor to be back, and we're really proud to be here. And man, it's nice to see people's faces again, so thank you.
Was it, actually George, I'll throw it to you because you've mentioned that it was sort of reflective of your youth in some ways. Is that true? And did you respond to it personally?
I did respond to it personally. I'm a young Irish Catholic who grew up in Kentucky, and I spent a lot of time in a bar as a child, naturally. I had an uncle who was a pretty good drinker, and I would spend the summers with him. But in general, Grant, we chased this book for years. Right?
Yeah, 16 years.
Yeah.
And it's a beautiful coming of age story, and it takes place in the time that we grew up.
Yeah.
And it just hit home for us.
Yeah, we're 35, so it was like 6 years.
I'm 25.
And Grant Monahan is the screenwriter. Can you talk a little bit about bringing him on and what that process was?
Well, he's the guy who wrote The Departed, so. It wasn't a whole lot of thought. He wanted to do it, and he's a fantastic writer.
It's true, and you have to have a fantastic writer to tell the story of a writer. Ben, can I ask about working with Ben? What's it like directing?
Okay, well, here's the thing. He was the cheapest actor we could get. We tried Matt Damon a little too much. It was a little too expensive.
He's much, much, much,
much more expensive. We tried all of them. We went through pretty much the list.
Brad Pitt was, we talked to Brad.
Robert Goulet was dead, you know. we went through pretty much everybody, and then he was Ben. No, listen, he was the first guy we thought of, and you'll see why. Ben is a wonderful actor. He doesn't always get the chance to do wonderful work. And this is a part that I'm really great for, and he responded.
That settled very slowly. For you as a director,
hey, I was Batman too, you.
So he's also well known for pranking you, so I imagine that was quite a fun shoot for you guys too.
It was fun. It's weird. We all had masks and shields and you're wearing all of that and then you go, okay, an action, and everyone rips it off and they pretend to be a family for 30 seconds. So it was more complicated right now, but we all get through it, right? We all got through. We're doing the best we can, and we'll all get through it.
And Daniel Ranieri is incredible.
It's odd for us to be talking about something you haven't seen. Everyone dies in the end. I hope that doesn't fuck us up. There's a kid in it. We were reading a bunch of kid actors, and we saw this kid on, was TikTok or something?
Facebook or something.
And he cusses like a sailor. Fucking lot, Daddy. And we were like, this kid's amazing. And we thought, well, why can't he play the part? And he ends up being, sometimes you just get lucky. He's a really wonderful actor.
He's really terrific. Do you want to say anything before we leave the audience with us?
Thanks for coming.
Nice to see you all. Thank you.
Thank you guys so much.